Knives, more than nearly any other product, are labeled as survival in the realm of outdoor gear. But with so much noise, how do you know which one deserves to be called the greatest survival knife of 2022? This is where we can help. To see all of our recommended purchases, scroll down or go straight to the category you're searching for. Number 1. Cold Steel Formax Scout. Over its stone-washed surface, the 4-inch blade has a drop-point design. When fully deployed, this beast stands 10 inches tall and weighs 10.19 ounces. The renowned Triad Lock is the calling card here. Many videos have been developed by Cold Steel to demonstrate the toughness of their exclusive mechanism. It has passed the manufacturer's numerous torture tests, so you can be assured that it will hold up in whatever survival situation you find yourself in. The deployment is the sole drawback. The Triad moves like an iron door, unlike some other folders that are quick and fidgety. The movement will be smooth as long as the pivots are oiled. However, all that strength implies that you're moving something substantial, not just a thin strip of lock bar. Overall, this Cold Steel folder is one of the heaviest on the market. The Formax Scout has you covered whether you're looking for a reliable daily vehicle or a backup to have in your survival pack. Number 2. SE Izzyla 2. When it comes to alternatives, I'd recommend getting SE Sheath as part of the package. It's made of sturdy plastic and has a strong metal clip and good blade retention. Normally, the Izzyla is slung over the shoulder strap of my hiking bag. It's cozy, convenient, and safe. It's so secure that you could definitely strap it to your ankle and execute your best Riverdance impression without it coming undone. But don't do that, it'll be strange. Keep an eye on the Izzyla Edge 2s if you're near any real rivers. The powder coating protects the rest of the blade well, but the sharpening area must be left bare. If you want to keep your 1095 in tip-top shape, clean it down and dry it before snapping it back into the sheath. Number 3. Spyderco Waterway. Waterway designer Lance Clinton is a lifelong knife aficionado and professional kayak fisherman who has spent literally thousands of hours on the water. According to Spyderco's website, the Waterway was designed by Clinton to be an ultra-corrosion-resistant knife that excels at fishing chores, while also being suitable for general utility and outdoor use. The key ingredient is LC200N, a high-nitrogen alloy tool steel specifically developed to offer outstanding corrosion resistance and extraordinary toughness, even at high degrees of hardness, according to the manufacturer. This effectively means that the Waterway will not rust, basically, ever. Where alternative corrosion-resistant steels, such as H1, are available, LC200N's edge retention is unrivaled. While it may not be ideal for Schwarzenegger-style survival, it would be an excellent addition to Tom Hanks' Castaway Survival Pack. Number 4. SE Laser Strike. SE enhanced the classic iteration with various new features in addition to its excellent edge. To begin, the brand replaced its 5.25-inch handle with micarta scales. A bow drill divot, for example, allows the knife to function as the upper part of a rudimentary kindling arrangement. Users can remove the flathead screws, keeping the scales in place with a supplied lanyard washer if they're in more severe need of a fire. A ferrocerium flint and a pair of tinder tabs are nestled against the inside steel, suitable for starting a fire in a variety of situations. Number 5. Gerber Strong Arm. Gerber's Strong Arm knife was created in the United States and is forged from 420HC steel. While this may appear to be a simple survival blade, I found its edge retention and hardness to be more than suitable for lengthy use. The sheath of the Strong Arm is full of alternatives. The multi-mount, snap-together sheath is simple to use and may be mounted vertically on maul, horizontally on a belt, or in conventional drop leg form. According to Gerber's website, the knife has good retention and feels good in the hand. The plastic, on the other hand, has a shabby feel to it. I've used a lot of superlatives in this review, but that's because the Gerber Strong Arm is truly exceptional. More than any other blade in my collection, I used it for camping, carving, and general tasks. Number 6. Fall Nivet A1. With a blade width of 0.24 inches against 0.19 inches on the laser strike, the A1 is wider across the shoulders. The grind is the most significant difference. The trademark convex edge of Fallniven is in use, enhancing edge retention and cutting effectiveness against natural materials like wood. It's a little more difficult to sharpen than a scandier saber, but the tougher nature of VG10 means you won't have to do it as often. The Kratton handle is another notable upgrade. While I like micarta, the A1's rubberized grip is more secure in damp or chilly weather. the forward finger guard, as well as the little flare at the back, contribute to the handle's security and comfort. The complete tang of the handle protrudes slightly from the back of the handle, giving you another striking or hammering alternative off after a while. Number 8. Kabar BK3 Tac Tool. Normally, I'd suggest going with a serrated survival knife. They're difficult to sharpen, don't work well on wood, and have a tendency to break up a great cutting edge. But if we're going to be silly, let's do it with the Kabar Becker BK3 Tac Tool. The handle is remarkably comparable to the old Becker BK2 handle. It has a thick zidel grip with a flared pommel that keeps the user's hand in position during high-stress work. The blade tang protrudes from the back, giving the tac tool yet another advantage. While most survival knives allow for some hammering or hacking, the BK3 is designed to chop, slice, and otherwise demolish a variety of natural and artificial materials. It's all about the edge all of the time. Thankfully, Kabar incorporates a sturdy polymer sheath to aid with the control of this monstrous blade. The tac tool's low-ish riding allows you to carry it at or below your belt line, preventing the exposed tang from poking you in the ribs. Check it out if all of this seems like fun to you. This knife is a little crazy, but it's also extremely well-made and a lot of fun to use. Number 9. Kabar Becker BK2. Its quarter-inch thickness tapers to a robust drop tip, making it ideal for stabbing and mild prying. However, as great as the specs are, they fall short of capturing the BK2's spirit. This is one of the toughest, most ready-to-use, and indestructible blades on the market. It has a broad-shouldered heaviness that gives the user confidence, allowing you to force through jobs that would make other knives hesitate. The Kabar Becker BK2 is as tough as they come, even if it isn't the most delicate slicer or the quickest fire starter. This is the knife for you if you need to break through bricks and pry a car door open in between trips to the woodpile. Number 10. Mourniv Spark. Without mentioning their handles, no talk of Mourniv would be complete. The Spark has a rubberized friction grip similar to the Companion, with a moderate palm swell. The comfort and solidity with which these knives are held are well known. Even while wearing cold gloves, its rounded form and unobtrusive finger guard provide a secure fit. If you're looking for flaws, the basic, though comfortable, plastic sheath and partial tang construction are the only significant drawbacks. The polymer sheath connects to the belt with a conventional belt clip, allowing it to ride securely and low on the hip. It's just molded plastic, but it's high-quality molded plastic. And when it comes to the partial taste, Mora has been doing it for decades. It's hardly a knife you'll want to bash through a car door or a tree with, but it'll get you through just about any other difficult circumstance. What's to stop you from buying the full batch at this price? Put them in your car, your camping backpack, or wherever else you need a tried-and-true tool. Which knives have piqued your interest? Please share your thoughts in the comments area. If you haven't already, subscribe to the channel and turn on the post notification for more amazing videos.